SQL Database in Fabric is now in public preview. Join us this week on a special edition of Data Exposed where I get to interview Anna Hoffman. Hello, I'm Bob Ward, and welcome to another episode of Data Exposed. Today on my show, I'm welcome with a guest. May you know, it's Anna Hoffman. Oh, wait, this is your show. What is happening here?
Thanks for having me on the show.
Great to be on your own show. Anna, some incredible news happened at Microsoft Ignite, something that you've been working really hard on with a lot of people on the team. It's SQL now in Microsoft Fabric? Why are we doing this?
Yeah, absolutely. And you know, it's exciting to be on this side of the show.
The tides have turned.
Thank you for helping us do this today.
Of course.
So I think the context for SQL Database in Fabric, which is now in public preview, is that we learned that 1 billion apps are going to be built in the next 5 years. And of these organizations that are building these apps, 87% of them think that AI is going to help them have a competitive edge. So when we thought about bringing SQL Database to Fabric, it's really these two things. Like, how can we help customers and developers build apps faster and easier? And how can we build them with AI in mind, both from a underlying tech that we use to make it their service run more autonomously, but also from the perspective of helping you build AI apps faster. So that's where we came to this kind of vision of delivering AI capabilities from ground to cloud to Fabric. And you know what? This is actually a term that you coined. So what's kind of your perspective on this?
I love it because I have for a while been pitching this idea of SQL ground to cloud because SQL runs everywhere you need it, whether it's on premises, Linux, containers, in cloud systems. But you have this underlying common theme, right, of the T-SQL query language. You have the database engine being the same. You have tools like SSMS. You have copilots now. And of course, you now have this standard AI story across all SQL properties. Right. Develop an AI app once and deploy it anywhere you need to. So yeah. I love us adding that Fabric piece to the end of the story. So yeah. I'm pretty excited.
Exactly. And yeah. For folks who might have missed it, earlier this week, we actually announced SQL Server 2025. And
Whoa.
That's a theme there too, right?
I think we did actually. And AI support that. And you know, we call it AI built in. So now AI being built into the on-premises SQL Server engine, those same exact capabilities exist now, work in the cloud or the Fabric.
Exactly, yeah. So we're excited to bring it to Fabric.
But a lot of people that may be watching this that are like SQL people don't know the Fabric. So what are the benefits of SQL being inside that Fabric platform?
Yeah, exactly. So for folks who haven't seen Microsoft Fabric before, it really is this simple, autonomous, streamlined experience to help you develop your BI and analytics solutions faster. Now, one of the things we've been hearing from customers is that they actually want to make Fabric their entire data platform. And how can you have a data platform without operational databases? So that's why we decided to put SQL Database into Microsoft Fabric. You see it here just along with all the other workloads. SQL Database is the first database to land in Fabric, but you could see other databases coming here soon. And across the whole stack, just like you mentioned, we have things like Copilot, all your data landing in one lake so you can do analytics, and then of course governance with Microsoft Purview. And really, when we went to build this, it's kind of different, a different mindset than how we've built anything for SQL Server or Azure SQL Database before. And we really embrace three key themes: simple, autonomous, and optimized for AI. So every time we thought about like, oh, how are we going to do X, Y, Z, we kept these three principles in mind. And again, this is so that we can help you build AI apps faster and easier than ever. Now, this is a pretty big announcement for us. What do you think?
Well, I'm pretty impressed because SQL people all over the world know and love this product for so long. But taking those same principles and applying the SQL engine, it's the same SQL engine, and doing on top of that could be lucrative for a lot of folks. Anna, this is Data Exposed, though. And on our show, we usually do demonstrations, right? You have something we can see?
Absolutely. So as part of this big announcement, you know, Satya talked about it. Scott Guthrie also featured it. And I got to do a demo in the session. So I thought, what better demo to show you guys than that one?
Absolutely.
You want to see it?
Yeah, let's see it.
All right, let's take a look.
I'm a developer at Contoso Wireless, a multinational cellular company. I've been tasked to add chat to the application so customers can get product recommendations and support. I've got the UI piece built, but it needs the latest AI models and access to our data. We have everything we need for our whole data platform in Fabric, and this now includes SQL Database, which is built on top of the SQL Server and Azure SQL Database Engine. One of the great things about Fabric is it makes getting started super easy. Let me show you how quickly I can set up a database. I just write a name and click create. Provisioning takes seconds. I can use Copilot to help jumpstart my work. It gives assistance designing my database and writing queries, both in line and in the chat. Here I'm asking Copilot how to automatically generate values for a column so I can develop my app. It explains several solutions like identity columns, default constraints, and computed columns, as well as the code needed to make it work. Now that you've seen how easy it is to get started, let's switch to the Fabric database we're using in production for our app. We're storing a lot of information related to the products that we sell, along with descriptions, inventory, order details, and more. Remember, since this is built on top of SQL Server and Azure SQL Database, it's got the T-SQL support you know and love, so I can write queries just as I'm already familiar with. In addition to T-SQL compatibility, managing these databases is easy. SQL databases in Fabric are zone redundant by default to keep them highly available. They're also secure by default and autonomous. Not only is my database auto-scaling to give me the best price performance, both from a compute and storage perspective, but it's also optimizing my indexes and applying the best practices by default. Now I need to implement the RAG pattern using our data to generate product recommendations for the chat app. With new native vector type support in SQL Database, I can easily make use of the latest AI models or any model in the Azure AI Foundry model catalog. I can generate embeddings, which are numerical representations of the data, for all the product data and store the vectors in my database. I can then use built-in functions like vector distance to search for results. SQL Database works with popular frameworks like LangChain and Semantic Kernel, which made it super easy for me to build a natural language chat experience with vector search. You can see here, I can search for similar phones to the Alva Phone X1 with a better camera. All the chat history is also stored in the SQL database, and all the data is fully integrated into one lake in Fabric as Delta Parquet. This means my data is available to seamlessly use in any other Fabric workload and anywhere across my organization. For example, I can connect Power BI directly to the data and even use Copilot to quickly generate a report. Let's ask for a breakdown of chat interactions by sentiment and number of turns. And just like that, Copilot has generated the report. And I can see that the more turns users are doing in the chat, the more often they're ending in a purchase. And since this is all integrated in Fabric, data updates in the SQL database are instantly available in my report. Switching back to look at my solution in Fabric, you can see how Fabric has become the data layer for my AI app, from my database and the report you just saw, to services related to event streaming and data pipelines, to the APIs my app uses, and more. With Fabric, you can build AI apps faster and easier than ever. Try it for free today.
All right, Bob, so now you've seen it. What do you think?
I love the demo because you showed this complete end-to-end story, building an app, showing like a web app, you know, chat app with an AI application, but showing that it's still the SQL engine, and then also the integration with things like Power BI. So I'm pretty impressed. Great demonstration. A lot of people could be excited about this. You've been on this project for a little bit of time now. Any customers give you feedback so far about it?
Yeah, absolutely. Actually, we've had a ton of customers, almost 300 customers engaged in our private preview, which is what we were running before now that we're in public preview. And customers are super excited about this. You know, some customers are using this for building their AI applications. And some customers have told us, you know, like, we want to make this our data platform. And there's a lot of scenarios that we're doing today that are a little bit related to their analytical workflows that they just need a database for. So we've seen use cases both in the operational databases space and more of kind of the analytics adjacent type of workload. So people are pretty excited about this. In fact, we had a couple customers who have used the word game changer to describe SQL database and Fabric. So this is just two of those customers, Hitachi and Save the Children. We've been really excited about the reception, and we're so excited to finally be out in the open where people can talk about this and learn more about it, and we can get the feedback.
I know it's been a long journey, and people are really excited to see this launch, especially yourself, right, to see it finally happen. So you know, for our audience here, they want to get started. Like, any tips or tricks for them to get going?
Absolutely. Yeah, I love this call to action.
I know,
line.
Call to action, exactly. I've learned from you. I've watched the show, yeah.
This is now available in public preview, which means anywhere you are in the world, you should be able to go to the Fabric site and just deploy SQL databases. If you have any issues, then you can ask your tenant admin to make sure that this is enabled for your tenant. Other than that, you can leverage the free trial where you get 60 days for free to try out SQL Database in Fabric and the rest of the Fabric platform. So please, we'll put some links in the description for you to learn more, but please go try this out and let us know what you think.
Well, Anna, thank you for being on your show today. Really enjoyed it. So for those of you in our audience, if you like this episode, please give us a like. And we really enjoy getting a chance to talk to you today about SQL and Fabric. We hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.